Hello again. Thank you for tuning in to episode 2.2 of our video series Parallel Programming and Optimization with Intel Xeon Phi coprocessors. In this video, I will discuss the general properties of the Intel Mi architecture in detail and then focus on vector instruction support. Let's take a look at the die organization diagram for the Knight's Corner chip on which the Xeon Phi coprocessor is built. The coprocessor contains 62 cores, of which 57, 60, or 61 are active. Those cores are connected to each other with a data bus called the Core Ring Interconnect. There are 8 memory controllers on the Core Ring Interconnect providing access to the onboard GDDR5 memory. The ring also interconnects components of the distributed tech directory, which helps to maintain cache coherency in parallel. Each core has a slice of the level 2 or L2 cache with hardware prefetcher. Together, the caches of all cores form a fully coherent aggregate cache. Inside the core, the level 2 cache is in turn cached by a level 1 or L1 cache. This memory hierarchy is extremely important from a programmer's point of view, because data locality and better memory access patterns can dramatically improve the performance of parallel applications. To see this, let us consider what happens in the hardware when an application running on the core accesses a data element at some memory address. There are 4 cases to consider. The first case is when data is not in the cache, either because it has never been accessed or because it has been evicted. The core will first check the local level 1 cache, and because the data is not there, the core will refer to the tech directory to check if the address is cached somewhere in the level 2 cache. After that, the core will request the cache line, which is 64 bytes long, from the memory controller, which then accesses the GDDR5 memory bank to get the cache line. This line is then copied over the level 2 cache of the local core and then to level 1 cache before it is finally used. This instruction is extremely costly, taking hundreds of cycles to complete. The second case is if the cache line is in cache of neighboring core. In this case, the core will refer to the tech directory to find out the location of the cache line and then request the cache line directly from the remote L2 cache. This instruction is far less costly and only takes tens of cycles. The third and fourth cases are the best cache scenarios, which are when the data is in the local level 2 and level 1 caches. In this case, the cache line can be obtained in about 10 cycles or 1 cycle from the level 2 and level 1 caches respectively. Therefore, data locality is the key to reducing the latency overhead of accessing memory and improving performance, especially for programs with intensive memory traffic. Now let's take a look at the core topology. As mentioned earlier, each core has a 512 kilobytes level 2 cache and a 64 kilobytes level 1 cache, 32 kilobytes for data and 32 kilobytes for instructions. The L2 cache has a hardware prefetcher which may help to hide data access latency, but the level 1 cache must rely on software prefetching. The compiler is often able to analyze memory access patterns of the application and insert the prefetch instructions whenever they are needed. The compute part of the core can be divided into 2 parts, the scalar unit and the vector processing unit, or VPU. For those who are not familiar with the vector instructions, we'll be covering this topic in the next episode. Each of the 60 cores in the coprocessor supports 4 hardware threads. Those hardware threads are similar to hyperthreads on Xeon processors. However, there is a difference. Hyperthreading switching in CPUs occurs dynamically depending on the load and data availability for the instructions in the thread's out-of-order buffer. And hardware threads always operate in round-robin order, processing sequentially in order instructions. For software developers, it is important to understand how to use those multiple hardware threads. Cores in Xeon Phi are what is called dual issue. It means instructions from each thread are tied every other cycle. Therefore, for compute-intensive applications, at least 2 hardware threads per core must be used. However, there are cases where other numbers of threads per core are beneficial. For example, for problems with significant data access latency, it is generally good to use 3 or 4 hardware threads per core in order to mask some of the latency. For bandwidth bound problems, 1 thread per core can yield better performance because anything more than 1 thread will incur thread contention on memory controllers. Therefore, there is no silver bullet value for the optimal number of threads per core, and some experimentation is required in order to find the thread count that provides the best possible performance.
In the next section, we'll start the discussion of the details of the Intel Xeon Phi Vector Instructions IMCI set. Thank you for tuning in, and we hope to see you in the next episode.